So, dear students, we have done first part of Reach for the Top. We have read about Santosh Yadav. So, there is a second part of the chapter is also. And in the second part of Reach for the Top, today we will be reading about Maria Sharapova. Okay. So, Maria Sharapova, it has been the brightest star of tennis. She is worldwide famous for playing tennis and she has got number one rank in 2005. Okay. She is basically considered as a style icon. And she is also famous for her movie star looks. But she is also famous for her powerful serve. Okay. She loves singing, eating chocolates, pancakes, drinking oranges, dancing, reading novels. Okay. And she is very much famous in the world of tennis. So from this chapter, we will come to know so many aspects of her traits, about her personality in detail. So let's start reading chapter, Reach for the Top, second part. Reach for the Top, second part. She was only 18 when she became famous in the world of tennis. Okay. She is a Russian girl. Okay. So when you will be able to complete this reading, you will be able to make a, you can say, comparison between both personalities. Santosh Yadav also and Maria Sharapova also. Okay. What is that according to you? So let's start reading about that. So Divya, you read first paragraph.
There is something disarming about Maria Sharapova. Something at odd with her ready smile and glamorous attire. And that something in her lifted her on Monday, 22 August 2005, to the world number one position in women's tennis. All this happened in almost no time. Poised beyond her years, the Siberian blonde teenager took just 4 years as a professional to reach the pinnacle.
So you can see her pic also in your books. It is a pic of Maria Sharapova. She won women's singles at Wimbledon in 2004. Last two sit separate. Within 1 minute, I don't want to listen. This is your responsibility to bring them. Sit separate. Those who are sitting together, sit separate. Adjust yourself. Adjust yourself on a vacant place. Laksh, I have to tell you separately. Sit separate. You just go there if there is a space. Every time I have to make you the same concept clear that don't sit together, don't sit together if there is a vacant space. And those who are without books, stand up. Those who don't have literature books, stand up. Because for last 1 week, literature has been going in class. We were reading Santosh Yadav for last 1 week and you people are coming to school without books. This is the reason that you break the rules. You create indiscipline in class. So what happened today? What happened today? Your chapter was over. You kept your book at home. Sit down and bring your books from tomorrow. Otherwise, I will not allow you to sit in my class. You have to stand at the back benches. So in this chapter, we have come to know about Maria Sharapova. There is something disarming. So disarming means remove feelings of unfriendliness or distrust. Write down its meaning. Remove feelings of unfriendliness and distrust. So this is the meaning of disarming. Remove feeling of unfriendliness and distrust. Okay. So there is something about Maria Sharapova that you cannot trust. Okay. And at odds. At odds means, what is the meaning of odds? Odds means strange. Write down the meanings of difficult words also. Only then you'll be able to understand the meaning of that text. Okay. So here, Maria Sharapova smile and about her glamorous, you can say. What is the meaning of glam? Yes. Meaning of glamorous is attractive. Stylish. About her attractive, glamorous looks are being discussed. Okay. Attire means way of dressing up. Attire, you can say dress, clothes. So here basically in this paragraph, her looks are being discussed, her attire, her style, her way of dressing. All these glamorous looks, these are being discussed, okay? But she proved herself on 22nd August 2005 when she got number one position in the field of tennis. And all these things happened in almost no time, okay? So poised means you can say dignified. Write down the meaning of poised. Poised means dignified. Dignified, respected. Okay, so poised here is dignified, self-assured. Okay. So she was, you can say, dignified. She was self-assured. It means she was having lots of confidence, lots of assurance on herself. Okay. So this Siberian born, it means she took birth in Siberia. So it was Siberian girl. Okay. And this teenager girl, she took hardly 4 years. And after that, she reached at a pinnacle. Pinnacle means you can say top, zenith, summit. Okay. So she reached at the highest point of success within 4 years. So pinnacle, you can write down zenith. It means top of success. Top of success. It means she was a Siberian girl. She took near about 4 years to reach at the summit, to reach at the zenith, on the top of the success. Okay. And she really proved herself in the field of tennis. Within 4 years, she made an eminent, she became an eminent personality. She became so famous and she proved herself that yes, she is something. Okay, everybody knew her with her name because of her achievement. And she got achievement in the field of tennis. Okay, at a very young age, she became famous. So this paragraph is clear. Shall I move further? Have you written the meanings of these difficult words? Only then the meaning of paragraph will be clear to you. Attire, you can say clothes. Poised means dignified, self-assured. And disarming means remove feelings of unfriendliness, distrust. Odds, you can say strange. And glamorous, you can say attractive, stylish. And pinnacle, you can say at the top, zenith, at the summit. Summit word, you can also write down. Clear? So this concept is clear to you. Shall I move further? Yes. Disarming, it is given in your first paragraph. Okay, so this passage is clear to you. So after that, we have next paragraph. In next paragraph, it is given that however, the rapid ascent in a fiercely competitive world began 9 years before with the level of sacrifice few children would be prepared to endure. Little Maria had not yet celebrated her 10th birthday when she was packed off to train in United States. That trip to Florida with her father Yuri launched her on the path of success and stardom, but it also required a heart-wrenching 2-year separation from her mother Yelena. The latter was compelled to stay back in Siberia because of visa restriction. The 9-year-old girl had already learned an important lesson in life that tennis excellence would only come at a price. So it means in this paragraph, we have come to know that to achieve such kind of success, it really required a lot of sacrifices. It doesn't mean that she was attaining success only in tennis. Step by step, she has to endure a lot. She has to tolerate a lot. So what kind of sacrifices she had to make? So this is all given in this paragraph. So for understanding this paragraph, there is a need to understand the meanings of difficult words. So you write down the meanings of these difficult words. Only then you'll be able to understand the meaning of second paragraph in detail. Because I don't want to run so fast. I want that my dear students should go in detail of each and every line. Because in MCQ, any kind of question can be asked. Okay? So you should be aware of that. Clear? So write down the meaning of rapid. Rapid means that is moving so quickly. Rapid means moving quickly. So write down the meaning of this word. If you have any objection, bachcha, you can go out and enjoy your life. Ascend. Ascend means to climb. Ascend means to climb. So write down these. Harnoor is not serious at all, and Jaskirat also. In my class, they both are busy with each other. Fiercely, fiercely means. Here, according to this passage, fiercely means powerful. Very much strong, powerful, ferocious. Powerful, or you can say it is ferocious. So you should keep these word meanings also in your mind. Okay. Competitive means when there is a strong competition. You can say there is a cutthroat competition. So write down the meaning of competitive. It means when we have cutthroat competition. What is the meaning of cutthroat competition? Strong competition. When one person is going to compete at a very, you can say, very less distance. Okay, suppose one student is standing first, he is getting 99.6 and second is on 99.5. So cut to cut, there is a very point difference. So this competition is known as cutthroat competition. So why I'm telling you such words side by side, so that you can enhance your vocabulary also in during writing skill, you can use such kind of phrases and words. So this is the benefit of reading, going through literature in detail. Okay. So there was a cutthroat competition. Endure, she has to tolerate, she has to suffer, she has to tolerate. So to gain such kind of success, she has to endure, she has to tolerate a lot. Okay, and launched. What is the meaning of launched? Launched means started. Okay, so keep all these words in your meaning, only then you'll be able to understand second paragraph, because second paragraph is not given clear. So many vocabulary words are given here, so you have to understand its meaning, only then you'll be able to understand its proper words, proper content. So stardom, what is stardom? Can anybody tell me? Yes, stardom means just like a star, as they get fame. So stardom is a process in which one person gets a fame. So in simple words, you can write down stardom means to become famous. Okay. And heart-wrenching means causing great sadness. Have you written these word meanings? So write down the meaning of heart. Wretching, creating sadness. Yes. So heart-wrenching means creating sadness. And separation means to be separate, maintain a gap. Okay. Compelled. What is the meaning of compelled? Yes. What is the meaning of compelled? Compelled means force. Compelled means force. Okay. Restrictions. Restrictions means, yes.
Ma'am, in the lines given, the later was. Ma'am, what is the meaning of the later was?
Wait. What? No, one of the student is asking me query from online. Who spoke? Dhiren?
Yes, ma'am.
What do you want to say?
Ma'am, in the line it is given, the later was compelled. Ma'am, what is the meaning of the later was?
Second person. Because in this paragraph, two persons are being mentioned. Okay. So, two persons are being mentioned and later one means the second one. Okay. I will be telling you this also. Okay. So, compelled. What is the meaning of compelled? Forced. Okay. So restriction means there were some limitations. So write down the meaning of obstacles means there are some hurdles and obstacles. Restrictions means there are some limitations. Some limitations she has to follow. Okay. And recalls means recollects. And terribly means very much. Okay. So here in this, we have come to know what was her father's name? Yuri. So what was her mother's name? Spellings are? So from this paragraph, we have come to know about his father, about her father and about her mother. Okay. So No doubt she was climbing on the ladder of her success so fast, so quickly. Okay, there was only climb and climb. She was not going down. It means she was getting only success and success. One after another, she was gaining another success. But in that competitive world, okay, and she has to spend near about 9 years. She started her journey at the age of 9 years, okay, but she has to sacrifice a lot at this little age. What was the sacrifice she has to make? That at the time of her 10th birthday, what happens on 10th birthday? You just imagine when you were 10 years old. You were not aware of all the obstacles and hardships of life. You wanted to attain only, you can say, gifts, etc. from your parents. You were having different kind of demands like that, because at that time, this age is full of innocence age. A child is quite innocent. At the age of 10, the child doesn't know so many, you can say, about hardships, about her targets, about her desires. Okay. So at that age, when she had not celebrated even her 10th birthday, she has to pack off and she has to move to United States, USA. Okay. And her trip was to what place? To Florida. Okay. And she has to go along with her father, only father, because there she wanted to. She was going on the path of her success and she was in the category of stardom. She was becoming famous. She was getting name and fame. So for that mission, she has to move to Florida along with her dad on her 10th birthday. Okay. And it really required a heart-wrenching 2-year separation. Heart-wrenching means very much a sadness moment. Because at that age, when she was moving to that, so there she had to stay near about for 2 years separate from her mother. At that age, to be separate from mother, you just imagine the child having age of 10. And that child, when that child has father also, mother also, but for getting stardom, for getting name and fame to prove herself, that child had to stay from her mother for 2 years. It was really an act of sacrifice. She has to tolerate this thing. She has to endure this pain. She has to endure this sadness. Okay? So she has to stay away from her mother, Yelena, and the latter was compelled to stay back. Who is latter one? Because first one who is being discussed, Yuri, father. And who is the second person who is being discussed here? Mother, Yelena. So Yelena, she has to stay in that sub area. Why so? Her mother could also accompany her. She could also go there. But there was visa restriction. There was limitation of visa. So only father could go, but mother had to stay. Okay. So at the age of 9, that girl, she has to learn a very important lesson of her life, okay? Because to be famous in tennis, it was not an easy task. So she has to pay this price for this name and fame. So this price was a less price? No. It was of great value. It was a very heavy price that she has to pay, because she has to go at that far distance without her mother because of tennis. Because such kind of circumstances were prevailing in her society that she has to go there because of visa restriction. Her mother couldn't accompany her. And for 2 years, she was getting training there. She was playing and she was proving herself in that place. Okay. Yes. I used to be so lonely, Maria Sharapova recalls. I missed my mother terribly. My father was working as much as he could to keep my tennis training going, so he couldn't see me either. So when she was proving herself in the field of tennis. Her father, he had to work a lot. Why so? To earn a lot of money. Why so? Because father had to pay a lot fee, etc., for charges for training, etc. So father, he had to pay a lot. So that's why she couldn't spend too much time with her father at that tender age. Okay. And she was feeling at that time so lonely. Father was not with her. Mother was also not with her. She was at a very far distance. Okay. So that's why she was missing her mother terribly. Terribly means she was missing her mother so badly. Okay. She was so away from her mother. And father, he had to work day and night in order to earn money. So this was a condition of their family. Because I was so young, I used to go to bed at 8 p.m. and other tennis people could come in at 11 p.m. and wake me up and order me to tidy up the room and clean it. She was so young. She used to go to bed at very early time. You can say 8 p.m. She used to go to bed. Okay. And other tennis pupils. Pupils means students. Those who were getting training in tennis field. They used to come at 11 p.m. And what was their habit? When they were coming at 11 p.m., you both girls are not serious in my class at all. Vanshika and Divyanshi. It's better that you sit separate. So other tennis people, they were coming at near about 11 p.m. Okay, they used to wake her up and they used to order her to tidy her room and clean up. So such kind of instructions were given by other tennis students. So at the time, if you were in that place, what would be your condition? Tell me. How would you feel if you are away from your parents and your classmates, other mates? They're also not giving you company. They are dominating you. So how would you feel?
Lonely.
Lonely? Okay, lonely, tensed, depressed. You would be able to compete with others? You would be able to compete. So there was a great lesson in her life at that time. Instead of being depressed, instead of becoming sad, she made up her mind to fight with such kind of all hurdles and obstacles. With such kind of circumstances, she planned to fight. And how did she do that? We will come to know from further reading. So Divya, you read fifth paragraph.
Instead of letting that depress me, I became more quietly determined and mentally tough. I learned how to take care of myself. I never thought of quitting because I knew what I wanted. When you come from nothing and you have nothing, then it makes you very hungry and determined. I would have put up with much more humiliations and insults than that to steady fast pursue my dream.
Okay, mark attendance of online students. Aryan, Dhiren, Ikjot, Jayati, Kriti Verma, Parmeet Singh, Sudiksha. So all these things could make her depressed, but instead of becoming depressed, sad, she became full determined. She became mentally tough, and now she learned how to tackle all these situations in her life. Not even a single time she thought that she should quit, because she knew this thing, that what she acquired, what she wanted to acquire, what she wanted to attain, what she wanted to achieve in her life. Okay. because she came from nothing. Because when she became something, she was nothing. She was not famous. She acquired all the things. So these things made her learn so many things, because she wanted that she should acquire, she should attain all the things. And whatever the humiliation, whatever the insults she were getting, she was getting, all the things were making her more strong. All the things were making her stronger and stronger, because she wanted to face all the things with courage, because she wanted to prove herself. She wanted to aspire for her dreams. She wanted to achieve her targets. She wanted to pursue her dreams. So this was the reason that she was moving in a firm position. Steadily means she was moving in a firm position, and she wanted to attain, she wanted to reach at the highest point. So these humiliations, these insults were making her strong. When other age mates, when other classmates were humiliating her, insulting her, she was not feeling depressed at all. She wanted to prove, yes, she could do this thing. So these small, small things were only, you can say, proved only stepping stones to success. Okay, so this was all about fifth paragraph. This is your homework. You go through up to fifth paragraph in detail. If you face any kind of difficulty, you can ask me in your next class. And rest of the text, we will be doing tomorrow. So we have 9 paragraph. We are able to read 5. Rest of the 4 paragraphs we will be doing tomorrow. Okay. Online students, I want to interact with you. See, there is a rock band activity. I have sent details also. Interested students can give me their names by today possibly. Okay, if you are interested, you can give me their names.